happening now. Who's watching? Steve Galdini's watching. Hi. Long time no see, no hug. Colleen. Yay. All of the crew is on time. 5 o'clock on the dot. Can you guys hear me okay? Everything's good. Just in time. I want to make sure everyone can hear me okay. Say hello. Hi, Trey. So awesome. Okay, I'm going to wait like a minute or two. There's a buzz. You know what? I was afraid of... Oh, you know what? I should probably put on my Bluetooth. And it'll help, I think. We'll do that. Sounds a little fuzzy. Shoot. So I'm in 100 degree weather, and the AC units outside are so loud, but like you can't get around it because then you need a fan blasting on you, and it's so freaking hot. So I apologize once the soft parts and when I sing and the music, it should be better. The quiet parts, maybe not so much. So, okay, apparently it sounds better. Well, that's good. Look at all this crew. Oops. Okay, good. Sean, yay. Thanks, JJ. Thank you guys for having me. So, yeah, I'm just waiting like another minute or so, and I think I'm going to start. I know I have friends joining me and family from, surprisingly, from all around the country, but that's what's wonderful about the theater, right? We have friends all around. There's my friend Trisha. She's in Arizona. We went to college together. Hi, Ben. So yeah, I guess I'm just gonna start. I know, you know, some of my friends will probably be late, and who knows who else is joining, but I am so excited here. You guys, Luzma! Luzma was in American Mariachi, not this version, but the one out. South Coast rep with me. So much has happened these last few years. Kelly. Hi, Kelly. Hi, Kelly. I have, like, the computer. I have an outline. I'm also very highly administrative, so I have my outline and my songs, everything ready to go. Thank you, Steve. Awesome. Well, it's already, like, 3 minutes past, and I know... Other people are joining. There's my friend Dino from high school. This is crazy. You guys are the best friends ever, seriously. Yeah. Honestly, my friends are, I've done shows across the nation in different states, and they always show up. I've had friends fly across the country. I've had friends drive to the next state, and I'm so grateful. You're so funny, Kelly. I look like a Latina goddess. Well, you know what? I am so grateful to be here. To be honest, like, I'll just say that I was a little kind of surprised because I haven't done a show at Moonlight since 2017, which was in the Heights. And I'm going to turn off these cameras on here because I'm just trying to put them on my computer. Yeah, I haven't done a show at Moonlight since 2017, and, you know, this time is so crazy, right? And we feel disconnected, even though we're really not disconnected. So I'm just really grateful because it's just a reminder how much we need each other and how important it is for us to support each other and do what we do and, you know, rise above. So I just feel like I'm here to represent a different perspective. And I'm so grateful that I have a voice, and that really I'm here because I just want to bring hope and joy in this crazy times, and hopefully inspire people and hopefully make you feel something when I sing. And yeah, just grateful to have some creative outlet and to get to, I wish I could see all your faces. So I'm thankful that you all made it here. If Yeah, just so you know, so I'm normally based in San Diego, California, but I'm actually in Arizona. I didn't plan on being here all this time. I came to actually visit my mom for a little bit before I was going to start a 6-month contract from May to October. And obviously, COVID-19 messed that up. But, you know, there's a lot of hard things going on. But yeah, so I'm here in Tucson, Arizona with my family, and I feel really grateful. And yeah, so I think I'm just gonna keep on going. I know people are gonna keep on tuning in. If I don't know you, thank you so much for taking your time off. I did my makeup for you. I put some duds. I put earrings and like real clothes on. I have like 3 or 4 yoga pants I live in, so I'm so happy to just feel a little bit normal. And yeah, I just do what I love, and so I hope you guys will enjoy this time. Yeah, I feel like this time is going to be a little bit about getting to know me, get to know about, and hopefully it inspires you and get to hear me sing some songs. Okay, so I actually moved from New York City to San Diego in 2009, and it's so funny. Right after I lived or moved from the city, I actually got called back for the Equity tour in the Heights for the role of Daniela. And I flew back out to New York and got to audition in front of Thomas Kail and the whole team. And it was terrifying. I was much younger then. And I ended up obviously not getting it. I was super devastated. But since then, I've played the role twice at some wonderful theaters. And my favorite production of that, of course, was at Moonlight Amphitheater. And it was truly a dream come true. James Vasquez directed that production, and Carlos Mendoza, who's a dear friend of mine, did the choreography. And if you didn't know, and thank you that you're here, you could be watching Hamilton on Disney Plus, but you are here. You can watch it after, and just like I'm going to watch it after. So, yeah, Lin-Manuel Miranda, if you didn't know, actually, his first big Broadway hit was In the Heights. So it's very dear to my heart for many, many reasons. I'll just talk to you about like the production that I was in. During that time of the run of the show at Moonlight, we actually had, if you remember, terrible, devastating hurricanes in Puerto Rico. We actually had a lot of cast members in our show who had family in Puerto Rico at the time, and they couldn't get in touch with them, and it was a really, really scary time for them. And so we really bonded because of that. We would pray together. We would just like know that that show was bigger than us at that time. And so, yeah, my favorite moment in that show was when I got to do Carnaval del Barrio. I don't know if you guys remember that number or not, but every night it was like, it was just like I felt like I was on another planet. Like it was just like surreal. And Carlos had this vision of us carrying all these different flags from different countries. And it was just emotional every night to see the faces in the audience, just like beaming with joy and pride. And then families kept on coming back several times to the show, and they would bring their flags, and they'd be standing up dancing with us. And just like it was crazy, and I am so grateful for that opportunity. As much as I would love to sing from In the Heights, I'm not going to because the songs are so, it's weird. They're just chopped up, and there's usually a dance number, or you need people, with you in the number. So I'm actually going to sing a song called Mi Tierra, which was the song I always auditioned for In the Heights for. It's written by Gloria Estefan, and it's actually now included in a musical about her life called On Your Feet. And it is a great warm up. We're just gonna do a little warm up right now, and I'm hoping that, I'm re restricted in my movement here, but you should definitely get up on your feet for the minute, and it looks like 23 seconds this song is. So join me in dancing, singing to Mi Tierra. All right, so let me get this jam going here. I have several sound things going. All right, Like I said, feel free to get up, dance, groove. Here we go. Because it's finally Friday, happy hour. This is my quarantini. It is H2O with a Costco olive with garlic and jalapeno because I'm Mexican and I need the spice. So if you are celebrating with me, just a little joy, grab your drink. You need to get a drink. I will be hydrating. I guess I call it the quarantini section because there's a couple of songs in here from a show where I kind of sang, it's called The World Goes Round. That was produced by Moonlight in 2014 at the Avo Playhouse. It was a musical review of Kendra and Ev, who are like my favorite. I love to sing their songs. It's just always kind of perfect for my voice and just a dream to sing. And also just personally, I feel like I really connect to those songs, and yeah, it was just a great team. Oh, it was directed by David Engel and Larry Rabin, who you saw last week's at the happy hour last week, and they're just wonderful, big Moonlight favorites. David was amazing. He really gave me a lot of confidence in myself at that time, and I remember a conversation with him. He was like, you should go equity. And that was back then, and that always kind of rang in my ear, and well, here we are today. So a lot of people know me in shows. Oh yeah, cheers, salud. Oh yeah, okay, someone's getting their margaritas. Okay, that's good. So there's been quite a few workers' comp cases made. Trust me, my last several years have been good. I've been clean, no injuries in shows. But the Moonlight, unfortunately, I had a couple, and they were, well, this one story I'm going to tell you about was definitely my fault. Okay, so it was closing weekend during World Goes Round, and there was a number, I forgot the name of the number. But anyway, so the whole concept was David wanted everyone to play an instrument. We're going to be this big band. It was going to be a big joyful number. And everyone in the cast could play an instrument. Like literally like, oh, I play the accordion. Like, and I was sitting there like, I play nothing. And so David would always make fun of me. So then him and I was like, well, I don't think we have this idea. We're like, I play all the most random instruments in the world. Like a kazoo. How about a ratchet? And they were like, great, let's do that. So the department provided me with a ratchet, like the most amazing giant wooden ratchet you've ever seen. And you know, it was hilarious, and I'm a ham, so at the end of the number, you know, we're all, like, coming to the finale of the song, and I, you know, I would swing the ratchet around my head, because it was a big finale, and in this moment, I swung it too hard at a very wrong angle, and it hit my head, and I gave myself a concussion, and that was at the matinee show, and then I was rushed between shows to the emergency room. Sure enough, I got it. They confirmed I had a concussion and said I shouldn't do the show. And I said, that is not on my watch. That is not going to happen. And so I, you know, decided that I was going to do the show. So we went from the emergency room. Let me just tell you, I'm still in my costume. This is how I recollect it, I think. I don't know. I had a concussion. The stage manager drove me back to the Oval Playhouse. And I pretty much remember going from the car and the emergency room straight on stage because I had the opening number. So I got to just park and bark that show, but I did the show. And that's what we do, right? We just, like, persevere. We're going to persevere, guys. So this next song was the opening number I just talked about. And I feel like this is a good, since it's quarantine section, if you want to play drinking game, if you just want to hydrate, that's also good too. So drink. How about the word round? When I say the word round, you drink a sip of your mocktini or cocktail, the water, and yeah, let's just do that. Okay. I have many things here. Okay. Sometimes your heart breaks with a deafening sound. got these comments now. Let's see. Aw, thanks, guys. Gunza. Hi, Brian Vanville and your new adorable baby. Yeah. I love you guys. Oh, good. Look at this. I love catching up on all this. You guys are so sweet. Did you guys drink? I'm drinking actual water now. Did you guys toast? I hope so. Okay. So, I wasn't going to do this other song that's also from World Goes Round just because I felt it was, I don't know, similar, like torchy, candor, or, you know, whatever. But my friend Trisha told me, give the people what they want. They're going to want to hear this song. So, I think I'm just going to get into that song. I think that, you know, honestly, Moonlight was therapy for me a lot. Like, a lot of people who I did shows with know that I was going through a hard time and heartbreak. But honestly, the Moonlight was the best therapy. And I had so many friends and so much support, and everyone was so loving. And, you know, I think it's just as long as, like, we can go through some hard times and despair, but there's always hope. There's always hope. So to me, that's what this song is. And it's called Maybe This Time from Cabaret. You might know it. Yeah. So just sing a song. Comments, you guys. Aw. I love you. Okay. Let's see what's next. This is fun. Oh, yes. Well, if you weren't here before, when you just heard my ratchet story, guess what? Since that time, since 2014, I've had to learn how to play instruments in two different shows. You're welcome. I can do it. I did it. And the first show I did it in was in Signa Theater's production of Gypsy. And I got to play Mazeppa, which was literally one of the most fun roles I've ever played in my life. Sean Murray directed that. It was just such a fun show. Gypsy's like one of my favorites. And I love me some Golden Age musicals. I learned the trumpet. If you don't know who Mazeppa is, I learned how to play the trumpet. And let me preface it. Okay, playing the trumpet very badly is a lot of work. A lot of work. I used to sit in the back seat of my car because I didn't want to disturb my neighbors practicing. And when I would practice in my apartment, I would hear people walking by and be clapping, which I guess is a good sign. But it's really hard work to be that bad. That show totally built my confidence, you know? Nothing builds your confidence like being in a bikini, long on a horn, between your legs, right? So, this won't be as exciting because I'm limited to what can happen and I probably wouldn't do that virtually anyway. So, I want to see if there's any comments here that I'm missing. Sarah Arrington, how are you? Oh my gosh. Okay, well, I guess, you know, I built that song up, so we might as well bump it with a trumpet. You know, it's a short version because you really need the other strippers with you, but I just had so much fun. I thought, why not do this song, right? Okay. Let this be a short one. Can pull all the stops out till they call the cops out. Grind your behind till you're banned. But you gotta get a gimmick if you wanna get a hand. You can sacrifice your sacro working in the back row. Boom, in a dump till you're dead. You wanna get ahead. That's how burlesque was born. So I but I do it with a horn. Once I was a schlepper, now I miss my zipper. With my revolution and dance, you gotta get a gimmick if you wanna stand a chance. And then the other strippers enter in its hilarity, and that is it. That's you gotta get a gimmick. Oh my gosh. Actually, I walked into that audition with a trumpet. Not knowing how to play it. That's how you book a show. Okay. Oh my gosh. Silly me. Okay. What's next? Oh yes. I also did, 2012. I did Legally Blonde, with John Vaughn. And, at that time I played Elle's mom, Whitney, the store manager. I played all of the featured adult ensemble roles. It's a niche. I actually met some of my most favorite friends in that show. I don't know if Danielle's on here or no. I might have missed it. I might have missed if Danielle's here. Anyway, if she's here, if she's not, Danielle Leva's Broyles now. She was single then, and now she married. We met each other during that show. And we actually got to do the show again at New Village Arts in 2018. And she played Elle, and I got to play Paulette, and I just love that role. And I just felt like it was such a dream to play that role. So, it's kind of a funny thing about talking about my niche. I have played a hairdresser in a show like probably the last few years, you guys. I don't know. So, I mean, I'm not surprised because my Thea, who I'm actually living with now, and my mom, I grew up in a salon. I grew up in a salon, and I just know that world, I guess, right? And so clearly it shows, and I have, played Paulette Legally Blonde in American Mariachi, which I'll talk about in a minute. I played Soylent, Colombian hairdresser. I played a hairdresser in the Heights twice. It's hilarious. Okay, so I'm going to sing one of my hairdresser songs, and it's Ireland, and it was really hard not to sing the song to Danielle's face and not make her crack up. So, let's sing the song. Where is it? Oh, shoot. I have some lines in this, so I have to make sure I have it queued up right. Okay. Pretend Elle Woods and then pull it. Whoa, whoa, whoa! Do you know the number one reason behind all bad hair decisions? Wait for the cue. It's love. You're lost without your love. Your heart is on the floor. I can help you. I've been there before. When I need to relax, I just put on some tracks from this CD I bought for the store. Isn't that relaxing? It's called Celtic Moods. When I'm lonely or feeling dejected, I play this and it never fails. I pretend like I'm in Ireland within you and the whales. When my telephone gets disconnected or I spend every night alone, I pretend like I'm in Ireland where the Irish bagpipes drone. Smell the grass as the rainstorm is ending. People smile as they stroll past their farms with a red-headed sailor named Brendan. And we dance without moving our arms. In a bar once I met this guy, Dewey. And he bought me like 14 beers. And he told me that he was from Ireland. So I lived with him 10 years. If he squinted, he looked like my sailor through my boozy delusional fog. Then he dumped me for some slut named Kayla. Took my trailer and took my dog. In Ireland, they know how to love you. You embrace in the misty Irish breeze. And if your Irish boy tires of you, you're allowed to shoot him in the knees. Hey, you look like that poster for Ireland. Long blonde hair and that sweet sunny face. Oh, no, wait. That's a poster for Sweden. Screw it. I'll never see either place. But a girl sweet as you has a future. You have hope as each new day dawns. Girls like you always get to see Ireland. Send my love to the leprechaun. So much fun. Oh my gosh. thanks. I'm glad that my hair is looking good because I'm feeling sweaty because I'm in Arizona. It's really hot. Okay, so that's that section. What time are we at? Oh, perfect. Okay. So I'm going to get a little sentimental a little bit. So actually last year, beginning of last year, 2018, I am 40 years old. I turned 40 last year, and my dream was always to pursue my dream full time. And like, you know, I was doing it, I was performing professionally and working full-time jobs, and I just said, you know what, now's the time. There's no other better time than the present to just, like, take a dive, and I quit my full-time job. I actually left my apartment, and I became equity. I got an equity contract, and then after that, I had, so I think it was, like, 5 equity contracts in a row, and that was through March of 2020, and my last show I did was Broadway just closed, and we had a couple of shows left, so that was like crazy. So yeah, and I said in the beginning I had another contract that was going to take me another 6 months, and that was a whole dream, and that got canceled because of COVID-19. But you know, We're gonna rise above this, and there'll be time. You know, like, I really do have hope for us, and I think if anyone can do it, our community is freaking, we persevere and we are resilient, right? So, yeah, so I was so grateful for In the Heights, too, just a side note, because I never really saw, or I never really resonated with shows with my ethnic background that, there's a poor wireless connection. Okay, it's back, I think. Okay. So anyway, In the Heights was my first experience with that. And then I just kept on searching for my identity. And once I had kind of like figured out, you know, and I wasn't afraid to just be who I am, I started working. So anyway, there's this song from Giant the Musical, written by Michael John Lacusa. And it's just so relevant for the times. And in this time of me being home, I really I don't know, there's a couple songs that have resonated with me. Oh, good. Connection didn't drop. Thanks, JJ. a couple songs that resonated with me, and I actually learned a couple songs. I'm going to try the song right now. And it's called There Is a Child. Let me find where it's at. Okay. Oh, I have to go to a different. I'm gonna start it later. Schoolsy. 1:29. There we go. I timed it, y'all. Okay. If you don't speak English, all your life your hands are tied. If you can't ask questions, then to you the world's denied. There is a child who's not aware. There's a world outside his little square. He must be sure how beautiful the square he's given is, and that he can get out of it and see the world is his. I'll teach my little ones how to move and jump. I'll teach my little ones not to feel defeat if we take the best of where we come from and the best of what we are. Something that no one can meet. There is a child who'll find his place. He won't have to hide or lie about his race. I'll teach that child how beautiful his future ought to be. And then one day
días como cuando mi amor por tu querer.
Borracha
y apasionada, no más por tu amor.
Cheers in that, were there? Wepa, okay, yes, yes. Cheers to that. And I swear it's water, I promise. Okay, so, okay, wow, I didn't even think I was gonna fill an hour, but we did it, we did it. Okay. I don't know. I guess I should have asked if there's questions or something. I feel like everyone here is like, people I freaking love so much. of course, I'm like ridiculous and I save like the hardest song and the newest song. Like, I don't, like, I'm singing, gonna sing a new song for you. And I'm a little nervous to sing it. But alas, you're all friends. And we have some grace in this time, right? So, yeah. Oh, it's sad. This went by super fast. I was, like, worried. Okay. Yeah. I, like I said before, I like to try out some songs that resonate with me during certain times. And, you know, it's just therapy. My friend, Julia, which I'm sure she's watching, she's one of my best friends, literally has got me through these times. She just had a heart procedure a couple of days ago, and she is healing, but she's one of the singers I trust the most with recommendations, and she's like a brilliant singer. So she told me I should sing this song, and it's called Change from a New Brain, and hopefully I don't screw it up. Like I said, I'm going to be looking at the sheet music. I'm not going to lie. But I like the song. Okay, I love you guys too. Oh, wait. What's the craziest thing that's ever happened to you in a show besides that concussion? Oh, that's so funny. Holy moly. I've broken my thumb before, my toe. I don't know. We all have stories, right? Yeah, I can't even think. Who knows? I've had stories, maybe like ask me offline, because some of them, like, maybe it's over just like one-on-one drinks instead of virtual drinks. You know what I'm saying? Okay. All right. So yeah, I guess I'm going to end it with this song and we'll see how this goes. Like I said, I have YouTube, I have like so many different music platforms. This is, yeah, I need to get a boyfriend. So if you guys like want to just shoot me a DM, you know, somebody who wants to, I'm just kidding. Maybe not kidding. Okay. I feel like I'm ridiculous. Okay. That's the wrong music. See, I told you I was gonna screw it up. Okay, there it is. Let's try this over again. Very quick intro. All right.
Pennies or nickels or dimes, we live in perilous times. I don't ask you to treat me nice. I'm not asking for friendly conversation.
I so I want you to know I love you. And seriously, every day, pray for the theater community and all the artists, musicians, everyone backstage, the producers, artistic directors, like literally everyone. Don't lose hope, okay? And I'm sincerely saying this from my heart. Do what you can to support those you love, those artists we all love. And yeah, you guys, we will come back. We will persevere. And I can't wait to see you guys all in person sometime soon. And yeah, I guess we did it. We did it, guys. And I don't know. I'm so grateful for this. So thank you for taking time out of your day. And I have the best of friends. And I love you. And thank you, Moonlight. Support Moonlight, please. Moonlight really, really was an amazing experience. 10 years of doing shows there, and I know it's not the last. It's very special for everyone in the theater community, in our community. So support them, guys, if you can. I know a lot of us are employed right now, but we can do what we can. Okay, that's it. Hope you had a great, finally, Friday happy hour. Now go watch Hamilton. Cheers.